I'm Sean Anderson. I'm a research scientist with Fisheries and Oceans Canada at Pacific Biological Station. Data from scientific surveys provide critical information for assessing the status of fish populations. However, there's debate about whether surveys that use gear such as bottom trawl and longline that can impact the seafloor and species should be allowed to continue within marine protected areas, or MPAs. In our paper, we looked at impacts of excluding scientific surveys from marine protected areas on indexes of abundance for groundfish, although other forms of survey restriction, such as from wind farms or budget cuts, would have similar impacts. For some species, excluding surveys had a minimal impact, but for others, especially those that started with more uncertainty, or those that became more or less associated with the MPAs over time, there were notable increases in bias and error in population trends. While any one set of survey reductions may be manageable, the concern is that if surveys are increasingly restricted, the impacts will continue to grow. We recommend maintaining at least some sampling effort within marine protected areas, as well as accelerating research into the calibration of other approaches, such as video and dive surveys, with existing survey approaches. But these methods may never be a complete solution, given the need for measurement of things like fish weight and age. Overall, our paper highlights that decisions around whether surveys should be allowed to continue in marine protected areas requires a careful balancing of marine protected area objectives with the needs for reliable monitoring.